Been what, 10 years since Operation Linda Nchi?
Right.
Kenya's foray into Somalia. A decade later, what lessons have we learned from that?
I think it's not been 10 years to the extent that Linda Nchi is defined. As you know, we got into Linda Nchi on the 14th of October 2011. And after 6 months, we rehatted. After achieving our objective. And the objective at the time of getting into Somalia in response to the provocation of the Al-Shabaab, in many ways, we as a country decided that we had to defend our sovereignty. And therefore, we were able to get into Somalia, okay, as a country and push the Al-Shabaab. And then later on, after 6 months, we joined AMISOM. We became a member of AMISOM. So we've been in AMISOM now for close to 10 years as part of the multinational force of over 22,000 soldiers out there. Now, there has been a lot of development over that period of time. You will know, for example, that the menace of Al-Shabaab was prevalent a lot in not just Kenya, but also even other neighboring countries. But you will agree with me that there has been drastic change in terms of the threats that we face from this menace of Al-Shabaab. We've also been able to liberate quite a number of areas. Today, if you were to visit our troops in Kismayu, you will not believe it, because Kismayu is alive with a lot of business activities taking place. There are no threats of Al-Shabaab. And the reason for that is because of the presence of AMISOM. And we are in AMISOM, we are in Kismayu, we are in major cities, towns that we've been able to liberate. And therefore, from the overall, we have achieved drastic milestones that was supposed to be achieved. Have we gotten to the end state? Not yet. The reason being that what has been happening over the last 10 years, we've been applying kinetic force. The kinetics where you are hitting on the enemy. What needs to be done now is to bring in development. People need to see development coming in, schools reopening, children going to school, and so that you can dry the pool where the Al-Shabaab recruits from. And that is what is going to happen now that we are getting into a period where AMISOM is being reconfigured. You will know that there is a debate coming up, the Security Council, that is looking at how the AMISOM can be reconfigured. And our thinking has always been, now that we have been able to degrade the threat, it is time for us to bring in other dimensions. We need to bring economic dimension. You need to bring in social development into this space. And so that you can open up the country, open up the roads, get infrastructure in place. And so that we can, at some point, get to a point where the Somali National Security Forces themselves can take over from us.
When you talk about reconfiguring AMISOM, and I know it's not up to the Kenyans alone, but 10 years later, do you see AMISOM still continuing for the next few? You still see them in the long term?
We see AMISOM, yes, continuing, because one of the challenges that you face in a place like Somalia, there is normally no peace to keep there. And therefore, you need forces that are willing to stand up the threat, stand up to the threat of Al-Shabaab. And the five countries currently in Somalia, Kenya, Ethiopia, Djibouti, Burundi, these are countries that have demonstrated the will to fight the Al-Shabaab. And I think, in my view, these countries will be still very useful in a reconfigured AMISOM. It is important that other actors come into play. And so that we can be able to pool resources to be able to do the final bit. And that final bit is what I'm saying, of ensuring that you dry the pool where the Al-Shabaab is recruiting. Mm. It is recruiting because there are no schools there. So children grow, there are no opportunities, there are no social amenities, so they end up joining the Al-Shabaab.
Yeah.
So this is an area where, as you know, the international community is very much aware of. You said you are in Sierra Leone.
That's right.
And that's exactly what happened out there. We did not just go there to get the RUF out of the place. The RUF went, but development came into play. And today is a thriving country.
Absolutely. Yeah.